11 years. That is all we would have left. From there on out, our days would be numbered. The world would panic. People would start getting dizzy, and slowly but surely, we would all start turning blue as we choked, gasping for air that simply wasn't there. Is there anything we could do to stop this mass extinction? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if the Earth was going to run out of oxygen in 2030? Blimey, I kind of feel like this is another one of those we all die videos. I don't know though, let's see how long we can all last. Before we get stuck into this video, why don't you guys let me know how long you can hold your breath for? I don't want anyone like passing out watching this video, but just let me know what your personal best is in the comments section down below. Honestly, I hate playing those games, even when you have to go for a tunnel and make a wish. Just like, I like breathing, you know? If you like our videos as much as you like breathing, then please do click on the thumbs up button and share this video with a friend. Stick around to the end where I'm going to be responding to some comments from a previous video. Okay, let's do this. So, I hate to break it to you guys right now, but actually, we are running out of oxygen, albeit slowly. Our atmosphere is leaking at 5 times 10 to the power of 25 molecules per second. Go figure. At this rate, it will be gone in billions of years, so no worries. We've actually lost a fair bit of oxygen since prehistoric times. It is thought that before dinosaurs walked the Earth, there was 30 to 35% oxygen in the air. These days, there's just 20.95% oxygen. It may surprise some of you to hear that the Earth's air isn't actually entirely oxygen already, but in fact, inhaling pure oxygen can kill you. We simply aren't used to it. Humans need a minimum oxygen concentration of 19.5% to stay healthy. When oxygen concentration drops from 19.5 to say 16% and you engage in physical activity, your cells fail to receive the oxygen needed to function correctly. Mental functions become impaired and respiration becomes very, very, very difficult. Respiration is especially hard if oxygen drops from 10 to 14%. At these levels, with any amount of physical activity, the body will simply become exhausted. Humans cannot survive with levels at 6% or lower. So if the oxygen was set to run out in the year 2030, then we would need to take decisive and preparatory action now. As in, right now. Firstly, in order to boost the dwindling oxygen we have left, we could try planting loads of trees and other flora and fauna. As we know, plant life undergoes photosynthesis and produces oxygen. We would also need to regulate how much oxygen was being used up in the burning of fuels. Oxygen allows fire to burn, and they do so by using up oxygen. Flights would be heavily restricted or grounded in an attempt to buy more time. If we were going to get socially and ethically corrupt, perhaps governments would put restraints on reproduction. Humans themselves breathe a lot of air, 7 to 8 liters in a minute, in fact, so more humans means actually more air being used, and the depletion situation is just getting a whole lot worse. Maybe governments would start dismantling the dairy industry, as cows en masse are a cause for increased carbon monoxide. Perhaps governments would go even further and start just killing off other animals in a bid to buy more oxygen for humans. Although, as we know from a lot of these videos, messing with the ecosystem is a terrible idea. We could try and mine oxygen from the Earth. After all, if we look beyond oxygen as a gas, it's actually one of the most abundant chemical elements on the Earth. About one half of the Earth's crust is made up of chemical compounds containing oxygen. And then there's the ocean. Hydrogen and oxygen floating around, doing its thing. Right now, hydrogen and oxygen can be separated by passing an electric current through water and collecting these two gases as they bubble off. But this uses a lot of electricity. We'd have 11 years to figure out how to do it sustainably or die. Another option would be to try and jettison off this planet altogether and live elsewhere, a place with much, much oxygen. The issues here are time and space. We don't have enough equipment to get everyone off Earth, and if we could, it would likely use up all of our resources, including our oxygen anyway. And also, the next habitable planet is 12 light years away, and without the ability to travel the speed of light, even with our fastest rockets, that would still take us over 220,000 years. And then, we don't really know what the other planets would have in store for us other than oxygen. There could be a whole manner of beasties waiting to kill us in different ways. The best chance of survival of the human race would perhaps be to pick small groups of humans and send them off into different areas of space, hoping they'd find a way to survive. A shot in the dark, but like, maybe our only shot? Say the time comes when the oxygen does run out though and we're all still left here on Earth. Well, in the time leading up to the depletion day, there would be mass panic, and actually, panicking is just about the worst thing you can do for oxygen consumption. And also, anything else? Did anything ever get solved by panicking? I don't think so. Instead, it would be advisable to save our breath. We could try holding our breath for as long as possible to keep what we do have with us. And then, of course, there would be the lucky souls who got their hands on supplies of breathable air from airplanes or hospitals. If I were them, I'd stay well away from the rest of the world's folk who would literally kill for it. Honestly, though, they're living on a clock anyway. The end result would be the same. First to die out would be the small animals like hummingbirds, and then the larger. Humans would feel tired and lethargic, and eventually the body would become so exhausted and would pass out, later dying as our brain stopped functioning. So what would be left of the world without oxygen? Well, without oxygen, there'd be no life. The world would be empty and bare, and plant life would die out too. The sky would become a lot darker, a lot like the sky towards the end of dusk. This is because there'd be fewer particles in the atmosphere to scatter the blue light from the sun, but honestly, who's even there to take in a lovely blue sky day? Buildings would crumble into ruin, and without an atmosphere, eventually the oceans would evaporate and the Earth could be left looking somewhat like Mars, but warmer. If aliens did finally come to visit, they may be stricken as they wonder what on Earth happened to Earth. So guys, that is that. No oxygen in the year 2030 and the end of humanity in just over a decade. Honestly, that would really suck. Don't worry though, it's not gonna happen. Not for a very, very, very long time anyway. However, just because the oxygen is sticking around for a bit doesn't mean our air quality is great. We're still polluting the air at an alarming rate and need to reconsider our life choices, if we like breathing easy, anyway. So that was that. What do you think would happen? How long can you hold your breath? Don't forget to let me know, but please do not pass out watching this video. It's just for fun. Before I go, I'm gonna read some comments from one of my most recent videos. What if we covered the Sahara in solar panels? Hot stuff. M. Adam said, right, and when some alien is looking at Earth and gets blinded by the glare and starts an intergalactic war, dot dot dot. Ooh, that sounds like a great sci-fi episode. Let's make it. Benjamin Steel King said, we need solar panels on every roof, which would skyrocket production, therefore the price would drop. Combine it with small wind turbines and excess energy stored as hydrogen under your house, and you can live off the grid. But my question for you is, what if Zordon the Eltar was real? That made me laugh so much, and I don't really know why, but if that's true, then I shotgun Pink Power Ranger. Of course. Are you listening, Julia? That's my sister. She'd always shotgun the pink one and I had to be yellow, but that time is up because I am the voice of a channel. Good. Thank you. If you like this video, make sure you leave a good thumbs up and share it with a friend. Why not ask a question in the comments section that you want answered in a future episode? For now though, I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. Please do stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.